What's going on, everybody? Thank you for tuning back into the channel. It's check-in day for myself. We are headed back to McMaster Hospital for a meeting with my doctor. This is standard. We knew that this would happen. When I first heard that we're doing a check-in, right, like a week and a half after my surgery, I was like, what the frick? Like, I'm gonna be down and out. Now I'm just like building with anticipation, just like wanting this to happen. I didn't really sleep much last night. I was up around like 4 a.m. to be honest. So I've been an early bird gets the worm, right? I'm doing that early bird. Everything from A to Z I've kind of been thinking about. Just building an anticipation of a very positive meeting that I'm about to have. So I have stitches in my body right now. I've never got stitches before. So I'm also like kind of like, how am I gonna feel like when they rip string out of my body? What's that gonna feel like? Because I've never had stitches before. I'm gonna show you guys the biggest tool that I use. It's this desk. It comes so in handy. So I'll do my work on here. Right now I'm eating on here, so I just have a piece of toast and some jam. To brush my teeth, I got my deodorant. How I brush my teeth, it's pretty simple. Put the toothpaste on, dip it in water, because you always have to do it wet. Brush teeth, spit into that one right there. Rinse with that one. Desk has come into handy. This is probably the biggest tool I use for my recovery. Just I place everything and anything on it. I work on here, I eat on here. Just got to the hospital here. This is my setup for when I'm driving in the patient transport. So it's like strapped in like that. It's kind of whack, honestly. We're rolling in. I'm just about to check in here at the hospital. Keep you updated on how it goes, but as soon as you walk in, it just smells so bad. I hate hospital smells. Ugh.
A few moments later.
We're outside. If you have been paying attention on social media, I was outside for the first time in 192 hours last week, and oh, felt good. Now it's just part of the routine getting out here. Today, I didn't really get much content. It was kind of like a wishy-washy day, to be honest. The meeting with my specialist, I will get into it, which was a solid positive meeting. However, the leading up to and after was just so up and down. My patient transfer was 20 minutes late. We were then 30 minutes late for my specialist appointment. We were in and out of there. It was kind of just like so quick and so rapid. Like I got to the hospital, immediately went into the room. We had a meeting with the doc, got my stitches out, and you know, I was sent on my way. So it was kind of like rapid. I was just living in the moment, being where my feet are, because it was a very important meeting. Just to see how the recovery is going and everything like that. However, I know I'm outside right now and I wanted to be outside, but look at all the sounds and I can't move. Like I'm in a fucking wheelchair. I can't move. Fucking tractors flying over here. Tractors going on over there. I can't just walk away or do it in my car or do it in my, like, trying to bring you guys a new environment. It's struggling over here. However, the meeting went well today. I am feeling much better than I was in the first week. Almost to the point where I'm moving my body without even thinking about or being aware of my limitations. So I had a good conversation about how to kind of reel myself back in when that happens. For instance, last night when I was sleeping, I woke up and my leg was way past where I was supposed to. However, I learned today when we're sleeping, if our body moves certain directions, that's okay because we're in a complete relaxation mode and our body will not be damaged in that resting mode. So that's good to know. He encouraged me to stay on the same regimen that we have been on. So the next 2 weeks is going to be difficult on myself because It's going to be the same routine every day. However, that's just the necessary steps for a full recovery. Along with the meeting today, I got my stitches out. I learned a couple more things about the medications I need to be taking. My TED stockings are finally coming off on Friday, which I'm so excited about. They've just started to be a nuisance in my rear end. I do want to touch on one thing. I am very athletic. I'm very outdoorsy person. I like spending time outdoors. And one thing that I have took for granted is the ability to do anything we want to do at any given moment. And when I fully recover, I will make sure that I do not take a day for granted. Just walking this earth, having the ability to go outside, having the ability to go run, having the ability to just, heck, go to the grocery store. I've took so much gratification for just little things day to day. I'm kind of just going, you know, through the calm bays right now until we can kind of kick it into high gear where I can start, you know, transitioning into more of the stages, which is stage 3 to 6. I appreciate everyone watching, following on the road to recovery. See you next time. For now, peace.